So, today I'm going to talk about perspective. Hundreds of channels have already done this. However, it's going to be my take on it. My recently, I've been forcing myself to learn it because I just know just quite how hard it is. As a professional illustrator and designer, or graphic designer, whatever you want to call me, I generally in my day-to-day, I don't have enough time to learn things. Go back and learn things I should have learned at the start. So I've just gone through my entire career just knowing the bare minimum perspective and never really learning it in full depth. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to go through one point perspective in this part, and I'm going to do another two parts, and then maybe a third part, another a fourth part. With how to place your characters in perspective, basic perspective, and how to put them on elevations, etc. So, for perspective, you want to start with a line across the middle, actually horizon line, and we'll do one point today, which is very simple. You just put a dot in the center, and you just start. This doesn't have to be really accurate. It's no if, buts, maybes, ands, or whatever you want to call it. So, but I don't know your experience with perspective, but generally, to see the underneath of a cube, it needs to be above the horizon line. And to see the top of the cube, it needs to be underneath the horizon line. And the horizon line is right across the center. To draw a square or a cube floating in the air, we'll just do a qu I'm going to freehand this because I don't want to be disingenuous. Realistically, you don't need to conform to a third point, which is up here, and there's no two point, it's just simple one point perspective. So you just invent these lines. That's not really that accurate, but you can kind of get the point. So I've just put a flat square. It's my first surface. And then my second, kind of like a rectangle, because this cube is going backwards in space towards this point. So these two lines go towards the vanishing point. These are just perpendicular lines that go to no vanishing points. In one point perspective, there's on you only follow one singular point towards the center. So say I want to draw another floating box over here. Is I'll just add in my one plane, and then I'll just add in my another surface. So there you get the 1, 2, 3. I get a 1, 2, 3 read. So this is the perfect like angle on a cube to read the form as a cube because you get to paint the values. So you can see that, even though it's very crude, you can see that that is now reading 1, 2, 3. And you check your values by zooming out. That's why I've done that. Now for the underneath, we're just going to do the exact same thing. So say I want to draw a little box. Generally, you saw how simple that was. So you just put one straight perpendicular line down. That'll be your first point for the surface. And then you want to do your Z axis, I think it's called. And then you do a parallel line to this line here. That gives you the back of the object. And then you just finish off the X axis. And then you want to do a parallel, two parallel lines for the front of the box. And another one there, and then you've got to kind of eyeball this in. Although realistically, if you want to get the perfect square on this side here, you just have to go back to this point and come to this corner here. However, just for this case, I'm going to eyeball this. It's just a quick, and it works in space. And I'm going to do a little one right next to him. So I'll do the same thing again. So these kind of taper, if you've noticed. So obviously, the faster the lines converge towards the horizon point, the more these the lines go towards the vanishing point, like converge quickly, which makes the cube more distorted. So as you see up here, the cube looks distorted because it's going back to the vanishing point quite quickly, because this is the distance from the vanishing point. Whereas if I draw a cube all the way out here, yet again, very rough. And you've got to make sure that you incorporate the underneath of the cube. So with 1 point perspective, 2 point perspective, 3 point perspective, it makes no difference at all. You need to make sure that these lines are angled in a way towards the vanishing point that you can see the underneath of the box in the drawing. Otherwise, it won't read as if it's above the horizon line. That's very important. That's the one thing I've learned recently when trying to teach myself. So we got a little cube next to our other cube here. And next we want, so say we want one in the foreground. We can put a little landmark down there. And we just imagine that there is a X going through it. And we kind of drive these lines towards the camera. So if you imagine this entire surface is the camera and you're looking into the center point here. So we want these parallel lines to come up now. So you just need to imagine where you want this box to start. So I'm imagining the corner of the box is here. Because I'm in Photoshop, I'll just use the shift tool there to make that nice and simple. And now you need to make sure that this goes far enough across to make sense for this line here, this surface that we already placed. So I've made this slightly taller, if you notice, because this box is taller. Let me just put some planes on it so you can see it better. Because this box here, number one, is taller in the perspective grid than this one, you won't see as much of the top surface because it's closer to this horizon line. So when you're designing your foreground elements in a 1 point perspective, you need to make sure that the top plane, it kind of gets squished because it's taller in the perspective, which means it's closer to the horizon line. And it's the same even when it's back here. So say I draw like a little cube freehand real quick. You would get, so unless it's a rectangle, that's to do with convergence. Unless it's a rectangle, so you see, even though this box is shorter than this one in the foreground, the reason that it's not getting flat on the top here is because it's not as tall. I'll just use this as my base. This is already, you can already tell this is going to be more squished. So I'm actually making a cube here. And then making sure. So it kind of looks like a PC case, but you see how this here is way more squished than this. It's because of how fast it's converging to the vanishing point, and because of how tall the object is that I've just drawn. And that's because it's also close to the horizon line. If you wanted to get very good at perspective, this is just how I like to be able to deal with it. And it does help me in my day-to-day work. Recently, I had to paint a lock for a project I can't disclose, but it just getting the right perspective that I have to do for the project, it helps. Because then you get the form, the dimension, and you can build a design on top of that. If you wanted to, you can just put another one there, pull that across. Let's make this a rectangle because we haven't got enough space. And this one's also going to be fairly squished, if you notice, because this line here is close to this horizon line. Yeah. So if you wanted to add one further up in front of this one, so you just do a line down, your perpendicular line, you create your surface following back to this perspective grid. This one's going to be off canvas, but you can kind of, I'm going to say the line is going across this direction. So we bring this line here and make that parallel to that line there. And then we've got, if you make these outer lines thick, which is quite an important thing because you can't see past them. And then you rub this bit out here. You see how that's coming forward in space? And this could go on forever. You could literally draw these forever. And my advice for you is, when I was learning to do this, do about 50 of these. Generally, just do, like, grab a sketchbook if you haven't got Photoshop. Grab Procreate if you've got an iPad, where you're probably doing Corel Painter and Flip Studio Paint. Just draw a bunch of boxes that lead towards the first point in this perspective. You will learn how to draw, say, a head. So I'm going to do a blocky head in one-point perspective. So I'll do a... But you need to make sure all these lines are kind of parallel to each other. And that's a trick I've learned as well when doing any perspectives. When you have a plane with lines that are converging towards a vanishing point, generally, depending on how quick the convergence is, they tend to be parallel. So, for example, if my second vanishing point was here and then the other one's way off the screen, the left-hand vanishing points lines on a cube are going to be very parallel, kind of like... Well, it's not great. So kind of... They would come at an angle, but they would be, like, parallel to each other. So kind of like that type of thing. It's very rough, but yeah. That's kind of how it would go. Yet again, you need to make sure that you can see the underneath of these boxes. Otherwise, they will not appear as if they are... You're looking up at the object. So there's a little rough head in space. Ooh, little googly eyes, nose. Draw that little skull. And you could do this endlessly. And it's very good practice. You can kind of get a just a feel for one-point perspective like this. So yeah, if you enjoyed, check my other tutorials out. More extended tutorials on this on my Gumroad, which I will put in the description. And make sure you subscribe and like the notification bell on to make sure that you get notifications when I post the second part of this video. And in that video, I will be covering two-point perspective. Thanks for watching. Peace out, guys.